Hello guys, welcome to this new video. Today I will talk about the Sony A6000. This camera is just here. But before that, I want to introduce myself because this video is my first one in English. So I'm a filmmaker and photographer. I started doing photography and video years and years ago. And I moved from France to UK to study film. I do videos on YouTube to share what I learned at uni because it's very expensive. And also because I want to learn with you, the community. Today I will review the Sony A6000. I use it to do my movie, but now I want to know how strong it is today. The video you just saw was recorded at 1080p, 25 images per second. No slow motion, even if the camera can record up to 60 frames per second. I use the natural picture profile without any changement and I just color grade after. The manual focus was the best for me because I don't really trust the camera to do autofocus. It's not one of the best, so I just prefer to do manual focus. On the top of that, you can focus peaking and magnification, so I think it's really enough to do the focus properly on this camera, even if the screen is not the best. The image quality is very close to the 5100 I already reviewed. The difference are more on the body than on the sensor. For example, you can use a microphone on the A6000 just by plugging a microphone from Sony here. Unfortunately, you cannot use another microphone like the Rode Video Mic Pro I'm using now because there is no mic jack on this camera. For example, if you want to use a microphone on the camera and a cable extension to put the microphone somewhere, you can't do that. You force it to use the microphone on the camera. And for me, today is quite a bad point. The sound quality from the camera is really not bad, but I recommend you to get the microphone if you want to buy this camera. This camera got the tilt screen that I hate a lot because unfortunately you cannot see yourself when you're recording. But if you want to record someone, it's pretty nice because you get at least the tilt and you can just be in many positions and see what you're recording. The Sony menus are not the best, but after using that for a while, now I get used to. So it's not really a bad point like people are saying online. I think if you get used to, you can really get what you want from the camera and get your menu as you want it to be. The record button is really not well placed because it's really difficult to press it and sometimes it can be very annoying. The problem is to charge the battery, you need to use a cable and charge with the camera. Why to not just send an external charger with a camera like that? It will be easier for everyone. On the top of that, if you get many batteries and you don't have like an external charger, you'll force it to just plug the camera and wait because you cannot use it at all. The video you just saw was recorded with a 35mm 1.4 Sigma, and because the lens is more important than the camera, with this lens I really improve the image quality and all the performance of the camera. For my movie, I record with the A6000 and Rokinon lenses, and I was kind of disappointed because the person, the camera operator, she didn't know how to use the GH5. I had the GH5 at this time, and we were forced to use the A6000. I was kind of a bit disappointed because I really wanted to use the GH5 for my movie. But after seeing the camera, I wasn't that much disappointed because the image quality was really nice. So if you get the money to buy good lenses, I think you can get pretty good image quality from this camera. Now let's go for the notation of the camera. I feel like not many people are doing that, but for me it's really interesting. So there's 10 categories and each category has got 2 points. First one, usability. For me, 0.5 is what this camera deserves because it's not like really friendly to use and there's many effort you need to do to really improve the usability of this camera. Second category, the screen. The screen is not that bright. At least you can tilt a little bit. So 0.75 is what it deserves. resolution and frame rate 1 out of 2 because it can record up to 60 FPS at 1080p. For me, it's the minimum today, so it's pretty like normal. Because the battery, you can get it for pretty cheap, but unfortunately, you need to buy an external charger. So I'll give him 1 out of 2. Reliability 1.5 because this camera is really reliable and you can use it pretty much everywhere. The price, I don't think today you can get this camera brand new. So used, you can get it about 300 or less than 300. So it's pretty a good price. It's almost the same as the Canon 200D or SL2. So obviously if I get a choice, I will choose the SL2 instead of this one. So for me, the price is 1 out of 2. The colors, obviously everyone knows that Sony doesn't have the best colors. I mean, on this camera particularly, I will give him 0.5. The lenses, there's no point to talk about. It's 2 out of 2 because Sony got really good lenses. There's so many companies doing lenses for Sony, so 2 out of 2. Accessories, because you cannot get like an external microphone, I will give him 1.5. Build quality 1.5 because this camera is really solid, and for now I didn't have any issue with the build quality of the camera. So in total you get 11.25 for this camera, and I think it's really good notation. It's really what the camera deserves on the APS-C market today. That's it for me guys, thank you for watching, don't forget to subscribe, and I see you soon for another review.